That's the same. I see everything change around me. They used to uplift me, now they ready to down me. If it's gonna be that way, they should have left me where they found me. I'm a young king, bow down the
Ain't none but a V thing. Okay, man, I'm back with another video, man. This Tupac Change featuring Talent. I never, like, I heard this song about Pac before, but I never really heard it, you know? But, like, this the video. So, like, I'm finna go ahead and tap into this. Rest in peace, Pac, first and foremost, man. You already know, one of the GOATs, you know? So, whoever watching this, man, hit that subscribe button, man. Hit that notification bell, man. Tap in with the channel. Hit the links below. Let's go ahead and get into it. See what Pac talking about, man. The GOAT, you know? One of the GOATs, man. One of the greats, you feel me? You feel me? Let's see what bro talking about, though. I probably heard this song, but I ain't hear it in a while type of shit, so I gotta, you know, rehear it again.
Ooh, yeah.
Ooh. Oh, yeah, I heard this shit, yeah. I heard this for sure. Of course I heard this. So this is probably one of the songs I actually don't know the lyrics to. Like, I really didn't study this song, like, how I like the rest of this song.
Come on, come on.
I see no changes. Wake up in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm black. My stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. God's give a damn about a negro. Pull a trigger, kill him, he's a hero. Get it to the kids who the hell cares. One less hungry mouth on the welfare. First ship him, don't let him deal with brothers. Give him guns, step back, watch them kill each other. It's time to fight back, that's what Huey said. Two shots.
Oh, game, bro. No, for real, though, man. He talking that shit, bro. I heard this before, yeah. But, like, yeah, Pac, man, I'm telling you, bro. Pac had different personalities in the sense of just being, like he had a protective instinct. He had a wise instinct of just knowing, like, oh, man, what's going on? But, like, when somebody ready to step on him, bro, he not going for that. He not going for that, you know? So it's like, with Pac, bro, people like, oh, yeah, he hypocritical. Nah, bro. He just acted in the moment, you know? Like, sometimes, like say for somebody try to punch you or something like that. It's called you protecting yourself. Like, somebody try to throw a blow at you, whatever the case may be. But he also stood for, like, being woke and aware type of stuff. Like, that never left his mentality of just being like, you know what? It's still stuff bigger than just, like, person on person stuff going on. Like, you know, it's a lot of stuff going on besides that. So I'm gonna give y'all this and I'm gonna give y'all that. You feel me? So, like, actually, man, I messed with him when he was rapping like this, bro. I don't think nobody was really rapping like this with him back then. Like, that was, like, around him in that Biggie era, you know? I mean, it's a lot of MCs that was talking about it, but he was deep with it.
Pull a trigger, kill him, he's a hero. Born even worse, I'm black. My stomach on and I ask myself, it's like worth living, should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm black. My stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. God's give a damn about a negro. Pull a trigger, kill him, he's a hero. Get it to the kids who the hell cares. One less hungry mouth on the welfare. Don't let him deal with brothers.
Okay, one less hungry mouth on the welfare, I'm telling you, bro.
Step back, watch them kill each other. On the welfare. First ship them, don't let them deal with brothers. Give them guns, step back, watch them kill each other. It's time to fight back, that's what Huey said. Two shots in the dark now, Huey said.
I don't love
my brothers, but we can never go nowhere.
Bro, nah, for real, though. Facts, though, man. Like, seriously, man. Like it's a lot of people that they was like that was rising against him that was young as even Fred Hampton, bro. Like, I was watching a movie, I think it's called Judas and the Messiah. They was telling his story on that, even though we know what happened to Fred Hampton, though. Like, he was 21, bro. Fred Hampton was 21. He had them like scared, bro, for some reason, because he was like, he wasn't like how the Muslims was when it came to the movement. Like, when what's that? Before Malcolm X discovered that it's more than just black people, it's Muslims and stuff across the world. Like, Fred Hampton was on some, like, getting everybody from a lot of cultures to stand with the situation, you know what I mean? So they didn't like that. They ain't like that at all. But Pac was definitely talking, bro. Hold on.
Unless we share with each other. For my brothers, but we can never go nowhere unless we share with each other. Two shots in the dark now, Huey's dead. I got love for my brothers, but we can never go nowhere unless we share with each other. We gotta start making changes. Learn to see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers. And that's how I'm supposed to be. I can the devil take a brother if he's close to me.
I want more to tell you, bro. This nigga was peace and war, bro. I'm telling you. People don't understand that, bro. They don't understand the concept of peace or war, bro. Just because you're a peacemaker don't mean you got to go to war, bro. I'm telling you, you still got to go to war, bro. You could be a peacemaker and you could still, people would think you're naive, bro. And they'll try to take advantage of it, bro. You can't let that happen.
Share with each other.
That's what people probably saw within him, bro. Like, oh, this nigga's soft. We were not from the tram. We were out of the bin, but that's when that war side comes.
Unless we share with each other. We gotta start making changes. Learn to see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers. And that's how it's supposed to be. How can the devil take a brother if he's close to me? I let it go back to when we played as kids, but things change. That's the way it is. Come on, come on.
That's just the way it is.
Oh, bro.
Things will never be the same.
Oh, bro. That's just the way it is. Oh, bro.
Oh, yeah.
I want to be, only way I've been practicing my whole life to live my life is to be responsible for what I do.
Oh, bro.
I don't know how to be responsible for what every black male did. Oh. I don't know. Yes, I am going to say that I'm a thug. That's because I came from the gutter.
Oh, bro, come on, man. Let's talk, Pop. He talking, bro. Hold on.
I want to be, only way I've... I want to be, only way I've been practicing my whole life to live my life is to be responsible for what I do.
Hold on, Mom, you said, only reason I've been proud of my whole life, hold on. Anyway, I know I'd be private in my whole life. Nah, for real, though, this facts, bro, hold on.
I want to be, only way I've been practicing my whole life to live my life is to be responsible for what I do. I don't know how to be responsible for what every black male did. I don't know. Yes, I am gonna say that I'm a thug. That's because I came from the gutter and I'm still here.
I see no changes. Bro, all I see is racist faces.
Bro, do you hear what he just said, bro? That's facts, bro. Like, he said, only reason I be private for my life because I want to be responsible for what I do. I don't look to the next person and blame them or think about, like, or even get this mindset like, oh, it's your fault, it's your fault, it's your fault. You know, like, you go through situations, right? But, like keep blaming people and having this mindset of just being, like, going back to places where you was before, even from childhood or anyway, bro. You can't take none of that shit back, bro. It's like you're living out and you grow from things, but at the same time, bro, when you do stuff or go through stuff or whatever the case may be, and you look the next person and blame them too much or anything like that, bro, a lot of things are never changing your life, bro. Sometimes, like, you got to take blames and be responsible for what you do sometimes on up to your actions. That's the only way your mental and your mind going to change about things. And then people will say that you changing, but they don't know, like, if I don't change, bro, how I'm gonna grow it? Ain't no such thing as not staying the same without and not growing, bro. It just makes sense. You know what I mean? So, like, I feel him on that, bro. Like, you're not responsible for what everybody else do. If nobody don't want to take responsibility for what they do, bro, it's like they'll never grow. They'll never grow, bro. I'm telling you, bro. That's why I say, bro, he said, I'm gonna respond for what I do, not for what every other black male do, even though he giving out messages. But Pac was always giving out messages as if, like, he talking to people. He not just, like, rapping, like, saying a lot of stuff. That's why I say, like I ain't gonna say, like, I messed with the music and stuff. Like, as I was a rap, like, when I was rapping, making music and stuff, like, I'm also, like, I rapped about bullshit at times, but I also rapped about, every time I even rapped about bullshit at times, it had meaningful, but all the time I make the most meaningful shit, but I had catchy shit too, but the meaningful shit always was coming from a place of just being like, I'm not finna keep talking about, or paint a picture like, oh, I'm effing, like, fucking all the females, get all the jewelry, all the, like, that's what make music so worded down all the time, bro. Now, And that's why I say, like, I be messing with it, though. Like, I don't mess with the music, but it's like, bro, after a while, you gonna be like, ah, like, it ain't no message. Like, it was some shit they was saying on the interview. They said Lord Jamal was talking about on the interview. You can be the most lyrical, talented person that got the bars, bro. But if you don't got a message, bro, it don't make sense. You gotta have a message, bro. The message have to be there, you know? My bad, hold on, I'll be talking a lot, bro.
I'm still here.
I see no changes.
Yes, I am gonna say that I'm a thug. That's because I came from the gutter and I'm still here.
Oh, bro.
I see no changes. All I see is racist faces. Misplaced hate makes disgrace to racist. We under. I wonder what it takes to make this one better place. Let's build and waste the wasted. Take the evil out the people, they'll be acting right. Cause both black and white and smoke tonight.
Hey, this nigga, hey. Type of shit you come in walking in the courtroom. Hold on, this nigga tweaking a lot. Hell nah. Hey, you have me as him walking in the courtroom or walking out that motherfucker. I don't know. Hey, folks coming up here. He coming up here walking like this. I don't know. Because there was some shit Pop said where he said, like, I don't care what you do, only God can judge me, whatever, on the interview. This nigga coming up here walking like this. He coming up here walking like that. Now, because I feel him, bro. Like, people are trying to take your joy, bro. I swear, man, you can't let nothing in this system, nothing, nobody take your joy, bro. You feel that, bro. You dissing yourself from that shit, bro. You got to, bro.
Tonight, and the only time we chillin'
mentally and physically.
When we kill each other, it takes skill to be real time to heal each other. And although it seems evident, we ain't ready to see a black president. It ain't a secret, don't conceal the fact of penitentiary.
Oh, yeah, he said president. Obama was the president, though.
And it's filled with blacks. But some things will never change. Try to show another way, but staying in the dope game. Now tell me what's a mother to do. Being real don't appeal to the brother in you. You gotta operate the easy way.
I made a G today.
But you made it in a sleazy way.
I gotta get paid. Well, hey.
He said you made a cheese today, but you made it in a sleazy way on bro. And that's I feel like that's saying like you made it in a compromising way, but you'll lose yourself type shit, you know? I don't know. Or just in a way of just like you making it sleazy way, like, oh man, just to make it I gotta go probably like pretty much, how can I say this? Like the environment I'm in, like, or something, like, in the sense of like poisoning my people or whatever. Some ain't no telling. Like it could mean that too. You know what I'm saying? Like people make it out. Like a lot of black artists or people that's from the gutter, they made these sleaze away probably in a way, just getting down on they own people or whatever. Ain't no telling, bro. Like get down somebody just to get up type shit. Ain't no telling. But I feel them on that. You like you poisoning your people or doing some other shit that made you become the millionaire, the richest person or whatever, or success or whatever. Like, you know, that's all it is. Because success comes from sacrifices. It's like love comes from sacrifices. A lot of things come with sacrifices, bro. You got to bend a little bit just to do something in this world, bro. And that's just how I look at it, bro.
You gotta operate.
Everything you do, like, come with sacrifice.
Brother and you, you gotta operate the easy too. Being real don't appeal to the brother and you. You gotta operate the easy way.
I made a G today.
But you made it in a sleazy way.
To the key. Oh, y'all see y'all.
But that's the way it is.
Exactly, y'all. Exactly what he said.
Come on. That's just the way it is.
Oh, bro.
It will never be the same.
Oh, man.
That's just the way it is. Oh, yeah. Oh, come on. That's just the way it is. Things will never be the
same. I'm telling you, bro. I feel like they was attacking Pac, bro, because his joy, bro. He was like, you could tell he was a joyful ass person, but people always seen him as this, like, this person that's just a gangster or whatever, bro, whatever, like. I don't understand, bro. Like, people always think, like you gotta be, like, even if you, like, I don't even think, like, Pac was just on some gangbanging shit just to be like, I'm gangbanging, bro. He was doing it to, like, people, sometimes people gangbang to start a movement. some people gangbangers, but I just want a name for some bullshit. Or is there some people be broken gangbanging, bro? And it'd be like you, as you can see, this nigga was a joyful person, joyful energy to be around. And people, when they see that shit, bro, they try to take it from you, bro. And you can't let them, bro. And that's just everybody. Like, it could be any type of situation, bro. So it's like as pop, like, people seem like they seen it as naiveness, bro. Oh, this nigga happy. This nigga da da da. This nigga doing this, smiling, whatever da da. This nigga he lighthearted. He got these type of things. So, boom, attack him. And that's when the other side come out on you, bro. You will start feeling like, you know what? Motherfuckers think I'm naive to this shit because I'm smiling, I'm laughing, I'm joking, I'm this and I'm that. I'm joyful. They see that shit and they start feeling like, you know what? Yeah, this nigga got a coward heart. This nigga a coward. This nigga this. This nigga that. This nigga. When they get to doing that shit, that's when you'll get to rising up and start being like, you know what? Play with me if you want to. You know, play with me, bro. I'm telling you, bro. That's all this nigga stood for, bro. I don't think he stood nothing but for that, bro. That's all he stood for, bro. I'm telling you, bro.
Things will never be the same. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's just the way it is. Oh yeah.
We gotta make a change.
Rap star and actor Tupac Shakur
was riding in his black BMW. 25-year-old rapper had long been
is also charged with
hundreds of letters ripped outside of nation as well. Cool. And pay their respect to the slain rapper.
Not guilty.
To survive. And still I see no changes. Can a brother get a little peace? It's war on the streets and a war in the Middle East. Instead of war on poverty, they got a war on drugs so the police can bother me.
He talking, bro.
To survive. And still I see no changes. Can a brother get a little peace?
Bro, he said we gotta do to survive, bro. For real, man. No, for real, bro. Like, when you, I'm telling you, man, when you in the gutter, bro, and you gotta compromise all this type of stuff, bro. Cause like, ain't nobody gonna respect you. Ain't nobody gonna try to treat you nut unless you succeed in this world or like hold some type of like things that you do, bro. Like, you gotta do something just for somebody to respect you, bro. And then you gotta provide for your family. You gotta provide for just people around you or whatever you gotta do, bro. And then people have, like, a lot of people would be like, oh, man, this person doing this. Like, it's all set up for failure, of course. But, like, bro, like, as people or just, like, as, okay, him as a male, bro. Like, if he got an OG, a girl, or homies or whatever the case may be, bro. And they see him as a leader, bro. Like, they like, okay, so they see Pac giving up. Like, oh, yeah, man, this nigga ain't this. He ain't that. He giving up. He ain't nothing. He ain't never going to succeed. Everybody think that about people, period. But, bro, ain't nobody going to respect you unless you purposeful and doing something that you, like, driven to do something in this world, bro. If you just, like, say, for example, if he was one of them, like, guys that just, like, you know what? I'm just walking around with a 40. I'm going to walk around with a 40, and I ain't going to do nothing in my life. Just walk around with a 40, go hang on the street, and not try to pursue anything. Bro, people would be treating him like shit. They would. But it's not even just success, bro. It's the fact that you determined. You got this mindset of just being purposeful. You know what I mean? So, like people don't even see him at, like, people might, if they see him like as a drunk on the corner, they gonna throw pennies at him, throw, pop his ass with a rubber band or some shit, smack his ass with a ravioli can, you know. But all I'm saying to say is, bro, like, people don't understand, like, man, like, when you purposeful and doing a lot of things, bro, people gonna respect you regardless of what, bro, because they see you. You driven, you stand for something, you know, you those type of things, bro. But I'm telling you, bro, like, I'm telling you, bro, people look past that shit, bro. I'm telling you, bro, because he says, war in the streets, we got to do is war in the streets in the Middle East, put a brother on drugs. Hold on, he said something.
school and pay their respect to the slain rapper.
Not guilty.
To survive. And still I see no changes. Can a brother get a little peace? It's war on the streets and a war in the Middle East. Instead of war on poverty, they got a war on drugs so the police can bother me.
They got a war on drugs so the police can bother me. I'm telling you, bro, that, like, man, y'all know what that mean, man. I ain't finna get into that. Y'all know exactly what that mean.
Poverty, they got a war on drugs so the police can bother me. And I ain't never did a crime, I ain't have to do. But now back with the facts, giving it back to you. Don't let them jack you up, back you up, crack you up, and pimp smack you up. They gotta learn to hold your own. They get jealous when they see you with your mobile phone. But tell the cops I can't touch this. I don't trust this. When they try to rush, I bust this. That's sound number two. You say it ain't cool, but mama didn't raise no fool.
Ooh,
and as long as I stay black, I got a stay strap, and I never get to lay back. Cause I always got to worry about the payback. Some buck that I roughed up way back.
That's the way it is. Okay, I'm telling you, bro. Like, you will have a past life shit to catch up with you, bro. That's why, like, when I be around certain places, bro. Like, even though I don't be in shit no more, bro. Whatever the case may be, bro. Like, bro, you'll have somebody you grew up with or whatever, bro. They not the same, bro. They see you, bro. They finna off your top, bro. It don't matter. You ain't gotta be on that no more. You ain't gotta be on none of that. They still try to off your top from who you was socialized with or who you associated with or who you was associated with or just because they just like, oh, yeah, this nigga think he different. This nigga think he this and he think he that. That's for everybody, though. That's for every situation, bro. So it's like... Like, Pac, bro, he most definitely stood, like, this is the part where they was scared of Pac at. All the other shit, I don't think they was really, like, but when it came to this, as far as the government or whatever, bro, the fact that he had a voice, and he's speaking like this, this the part they was scared of. So they like, you know what, I'm finna get to throwing dirt on this nigga. I'm finna make him look like a fool or whatever. Like, they was scared of this part, bro. I'm telling you, bro, the government will never be scared of you doing this. And this and videos, bro. This what the government scared of. This, let me show you what the government scared of from black motherfuckers. This is what they scared of, bro. Hold on. This what they scared of. This what they scared for you to do. This what they scared for you to do, bro. They scared of this. When you open this shit up and get to gaining knowledge and shit, bro. That's what they really scared of, bro. They'll never be scared of you. Shooting them up, trying to go shoot your own, like your own kind, or do some weird shit and promoting the wrong shit and saying like, oh man, we gonna, this is my block, this, that, bro, they ain't scared of that shit. That's why they was making it so hard for them black leaders and shit back then, or whoever leaders that was trying to make shit change. That's what they was scared of, bro. They was educating themselves and trying to make change about shit, bro. They not scared of no motherfucker. Saying, like, I'm going to go shoot you because you killed my homie, da, 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 or threatening them with violence and shit. They not scared of that shit, bro. They I'm telling you, bro.
That's just the way.
They scared of change. So when motherfuckers see that type of shit, bro, they man, I'm telling you, bro.
It is. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh yeah.
Yeah, I fuck with that song. I ain't hear that in a while though, but I like that though. But that's what I'm saying, bro. Like they scatter that type of shit, bro. They don't want people to change, bro. Like make change. Like what they think with these people, like, okay, give them a record deal. Give him some type of deal. Give him something. And he gonna fall in line just because we giving him some money. He sounds suppressed. He wanna eat. He poor, his stomach growling. So we finna give him some money and tell him to shut up and do and entertain and do what we want you to do. That's all that should be. But like at the same time, bro, they don't think, bro, when you get money or any type of thing, bro, and this is why a lot of people that got money, they fall off, bro. They get these 360 deals, like they start a $2 million deal in their face, or whatever the case may be, and be like, you got a 3-year contract for $2 million. That ain't nothing due to taxes and everything you gotta do promotion music, all that shit, $2 million is not nothing. Then you got to own them for shows and shit. The only way you make money in the music industry is shows, really, and your endorsement deals and all your side businesses, like the core enterprises, the music, though. So they get people like this, like, nowadays, they like, a lot of, that's why a lot of rappers fall off, because they don't come up as themselves, bro. They don't educate themselves, bro. They don't do those type of things, so they'll fall off or whatever, or just fall in the shadows, bro. But, like, people like them, bro, like how Pac was, bro, they was too smart for that shit, bro. And I ain't say, like, a lot of rappers now ain't smart, but they just don't. If you got something going on in the background, bro, speak that shit. But, like, they don't want to change that shit up because they scared they gonna lose their fans. Bro, I don't care. If I'm a rapper, bro, and I see, like, a greater purpose or any type of thing or whatever, I can still vent, of course. But if I still see shit like I'm learning something, I'm gonna give that shit out. Don't sit right there and hold it. Give it out, bro. Like, if they think you, like, oh, I know you know better, so I'm gonna get this out. I'm gonna give that out, bro. Why hold that shit in, bro? So, like, that being said, people be scared to lose fans, bro. But they think, like, oh, because I'm gonna lose money. But, man, you lose shit and you gain some shit, bro. That's how you dope go, bro, in this world. If you lose some shit, you gonna gain something else, bro. But, yeah, I'm not gonna talk, bro. I'm not gonna talk, man. I'll be talking a lot. But, but yeah, man, that was Tupac, Change, Future, and Talent. Y'all got loud me, y'all vibe me, so subscribe me, man. Hit them links below, man. I'm gone.